There's an exciting FAA-approved next-gen AWOS system installed at over 70 airports and heliports across the United States. It's called SuperAWOS. SuperAWOS does a lot more than your traditional AWOS, so let me take a moment to show off some of its unique features. SuperAWOS provides four primary services to pilots. It greets inbound pilots, informing them of its presence and how to use it. It provides complete advisories, including required weather, traffic, and other information, a complete two-way radio check, and pre-flight planning information for pilots. SuperAWOS is like having a pilot and weather observer standing by your airport 24/7, always ready to serve your pilots. As I'm approaching any airport, my first concern is to avoid mid-air collision. Because I've just turned to the Unicom frequency, I have no idea what other aircraft may already be in the area or what they're doing. Instead of going off frequency to listen to a traditional AWOS, with SuperAWOS I stay right on the traffic frequency, listening for traffic. When it's this quiet, I always make a blind call to the frequency. 86121 inbound, request advisories.
Good evening. This is Atomic Airfield Automated Advisory. Wind 280 at 4. Altimeter 3002.
Conditions favor runway 24. Right. Traffic. Pilot's discretion.
SuperAWOS actually noticed that no one else responded to me, so it did. SuperAWOS just gave me all the information I need. The runway with the best headwind for landing or takeoff, a reminder to use right traffic for runway 24, and pilot's discretion tells me there's probably no one else in the area, so I can now set up for runway 24.
For further services, click your mic 3 times for an advisory, 4 times for radio check.
Because the frequency was quiet, in addition to greeting me, the system also decided there was time to explain how to use it. 3 clicks activates an advisory.
Atomic Airfield Automated Advisory. Wind 280 at 4. Altimeter 3002.
Notice how the message became shorter. Most of the time, you'll just get the most minimal information. SuperAWOS adds other parameters only as they become important, like visibility or density altitude. When they're not important, it drops them out of the Unicom chatter entirely.
Atomic Airfield. Updated advisory. Wind dial 280 at 21. Caution. Crosswind. Wind shear.
SuperAWOS even knows how conditions affect a pilot. Because the winds shifted significantly since it was last call, SuperAWOS automatically gave me heads up that things have changed. Crosswind tells me to anticipate strong wind component across the runway. Wind shear means I can expect significant fluctuations of my airspeed on final. Because of these warnings, I can plan accordingly, assuring the greatest margin of safety. By staying on Unicom, I can maintain continuous traffic awareness by listening to the position reports of other aircraft. SuperAWOS brings the other information I need right onto the Unicom so I can keep monitoring other traffic. When the airport gets busy, SuperAWOS adapts its transmissions to only giving the most critical information based on what the pilot needs right now, adjusted for the level of frequency congestion. It gives me just the information I need at just the time I need it, and no more. SuperAWOS is continuously adapting the balance between safety information and Unicom congestion.
Atomic Airfield Automated Advisory. Wind 280 at 14. Altimeter 2 9 9 9. For runway, listen for traffic.
Listen for traffic tells me there are other aircraft in the airport area, so I need to pay attention to what those aircraft are doing. In low visibility IFR conditions like this, I can't see anything outside. My course comes from following electronic signals like GPS, VORs, etc. When I'm ready to land at my destination airport, I descend down that airport's published instrument approach procedure. An electronic 3D course which takes me safely down to just above the runway. If I can see the airport before I get to the bottom of the procedure, decision height on an ILS, or minimum descent altitude on a non-precision approach, I land. If I get to the bottom of the procedure and can't see the airport, I go missed approach and either try again or go elsewhere. When visibility becomes important, SuperAWOS adds visibility to its message.
Atomic Airfield Automated Advisory. Wind 200 at 4. Visibility 2 miles. Altimeter 2 9 9 9.
All IFR operations need local altimeter to maintain clearance from unseen obstructions below, and commercial operators also need to know the visibilities above minimums before they're authorized to start down the approach. SuperAWOS has already told me I'm well above minimums, so I know what to expect on landing. Every flight is a series of decisions. At the airport, my first decision is to determine which runway gives me a better headwind, to shorten my takeoff roll, and to maximize my rate of climb. SuperAWOS only answers with the most critical information, but if I want to force all of the weather information, I can simply follow the first request another 3 clicks.
Atomic Airfield, automated advisory, wind 280 at 14, visibility 2 miles, altimeter 2999. Atomic Airfield, extended advisory, wind 280 at 14, caution, crosswind, visibility 2 miles, temperature 102.-8 Celsius, altimeter 2999, density altitude 7500.
Once I leave the ground, my only contact with other aircraft or air traffic control will be through my radios. Therefore, before I take off, just like I always make sure my controls are free and clear, I also confirm transmitting and receiving clearly with a radio check. This is especially critical for IFR operations and for training environment, where loss of comm, only discovered after takeoff, can suddenly become critical. 4 clicks activates the radio check.
Transmit radio check.
1-2-1, check comm.
10-10.
SuperAWOS's unique echo check allows me to actually hear how my transmissions are sent and received by others to my aircraft. If the frequency isn't too busy, SuperAWOS adds a relative power figure, which is a great way to spot a radio problem before a takeoff. When high temperature or high altitude significantly affect aircraft takeoff performance, SuperAWOS adds a warning of density altitude to my pre-takeoff radio check, when time on frequency permits.
Transmit radio check.
1-2-1, check comm. 1-2-1, check comm.
Caution, density altitude 7000.
This is a real lifesaver, especially at high altitude airports when most density altitude accidents occur. If the frequency gets busy, there's another way to do a really quick radio check. Just click 4 times and start your radio check message immediately.
1-2-1, check comm.
Potomac traffic 86121s taking the active, Potomac. SuperAWOS does something else special. It detects aircraft 12115 MHz ELTs, which no one else is listening to anymore. It's reassuring to know that if you have an accident late at night or when nobody's around, SuperAWOS scans for your aircraft's ELT and reports directly to Air Force Rescue for the quickest coordinated response. For flight planning, pilots need to know what to expect en route and at their destination. Weather information from all SuperAWOS sites is gathered together centrally by satellite to our servers, where it is available to pilots by telephone and by web, and over an ever-expanding list of additional weather networks. When forecasts suggest IFR conditions are likely, pilots are required to file a backup or alternate airport in case they can't make it into their primary destination. Private and commercial operators are all authorized to use any and all forecasts to make this determination. Traditionally, AWOS systems were designed primarily as scientific stations, providing slow-moving averages for trend analysis and for National Weather Service forecast models. SuperAWOS is all about aviation. For example, real-time winds, like a talking windsock, plus AWOS winds remotely for flight planning. Pilots sometimes ask why SuperAWOS doesn't give ceiling over the Unicom. There are a couple of good reasons. Although interesting, ceiling hasn't been a flight requirement since 1967. Accepted sensors are terribly expensive for the airport to maintain. And frankly, laser ceilingometers, which only look at one tiny point in the sky, can only be so accurate. Pilots are also required to have temperature, but every aircraft already has this on board. The only parameters actually needed to be certified to unlock flight operations are altimeter and visibility. Everything else can be advisory. In fact, SuperAWOS is the first AWOS actually designed specifically for aviation, by airport owners and pilots, for airport owners and pilots. Not only does SuperAWOS do everything a traditional AWOS can do, SuperAWOS does a whole lot more. That's why we call it SuperAWOS. We're proud of the system's many unique and patented features and hope you will come join our many other airports. Feel free to see our website at www.superawos.com or call us at 800-207-8999. We'd love to hear from you. Happy landings, and let us know what you think. Thanks.